I've been told that in the first video I didn't state my case for this project very well, so here we go with take two. I mean, the first thing that I want to say to any women who are watching this is the old days are gone. I mean, our IT department is now a 50-50 split. So if you there should be no stigma to following this project if you want to. Indeed, one of the main things that I see from people who are learning about computers is that they get a Windows computer, they learn where in the operating system all the options are to control it, and maybe they'll even put a CD in and install the operating system themselves on a machine. But that doesn't really give them the foundation knowledge of component electronics and how things really hang together. And that's what I'm hoping that this project will start to introduce. Because one of the things that concerns me is the number of people, or the lack of people, who seem to be following into component electronics. I mean, Britain used to be an incredible country, and still is at the moment, for inventions in that avenue. But it does concern me, because a knowledge of electronics can make a major difference to your life, and it can sort out a lot of those minor niggles. One example was one of my aunties is profoundly deaf. Her husband rigged up a system so that if somebody rang the doorbell or if the phone rang, a light system would flash throughout the house so that she'd know and be aware. And it was his knowledge of electronics that let him do that. So we're not going to get too deep down into the component level stuff. Just enough for this project to get things running and to get things moving, because a lot of the modern stuff is just so so detailed. I mean, the soldering work is done by machine, so a human being trying to solder that just doesn't stand a hope. So a lot of what we do in terms of the soldering work won't really help you with PCs. I mean, that's still restricted to board level stuff, but it's good to get your hands dirty. Increase the understanding of what you're doing. So that's one of the things. So we are going to do put some resistors to boards and things like that. And the first few videos here are going to be about getting the machine, getting some of the main faults out of the way, examining the options and hooking up the hardware. So the first few videos are going to be hardware orientated, because it's going to be a case of putting things together. I mean, that's what this section is going to be about. When they're together, then we're going to go on to things like the software. And through doing the software, you're going to work out, see how the software and the hardware work together, and how it all hangs together. We're not going to go into, I'm not going to wind up with co-processors and stuff like that, but probably we'll hook up a floppy drive, the SD system, work out the video, getting that sorted and hooked up. So this is not going to be a small project. It's going to go over a fair number of months, getting all this together. One of the things that you will find with the MMC card, I keep calling it an SD card, it's not, it's an MMC card project, is that it comes with a CD-ROM, and on that are some programs you can run on the beep. So while you're learning and doing things, you can be involved in a little bit of retro gaming. That's the hope with this project, in that you'll learn more about how things go together, how the machines actually work, the foundations of computing. And I mean, I'm halfway through my career now. There's no way I'm going to switch into electronics, but you never know, it might start a few other people off. So good luck. The next project will be on the video systems, hooking them up to TVs and monitors, and I think I'm halfway through it now. It'll probably take me another couple of weeks, so keep an eye, and I'll catch you in a bit. I'm not working off the teleprompter, so I forgot to give a shout out to all the people who are helping me out on this. I mean, it's been 25 years plus since I've had my hands on a BBCB. And if it wasn't for the people on the forums, the people who are talking with me via email, and my friends who are component level engineers and can literally visit, I mean, I wouldn't stand a chance. I mean, one of my aims in doing this video is to translate a lot of the text, because there's a lot of information up on the internet. I want to translate that text and some of the pictures into actual video to show you the hands-on things that you can do. And if it wasn't for them, I don't think I'd get this project off the ground. So yeah, a shout out to all those people, and I'll start mentioning individual forums and company names as we start going on through this. One of the aspects of this is actually a sense of achievement in actually overcoming stuff and doing things with your own hands. That seems to be a thing that a lot of people have lost, have completely forgotten about. But yeah, doing things, doing something and actually achieving something is great. And with this sort of thing, the results should be almost immediate. Cost-wise, what are we looking at? Well, you're going to need some tools. You're going to need a soldering iron. You're going to need a stand to put the soldering iron on, because it's going to get so hot you can't put it down on the desk or something, so it will start a fire. So you're going to need a stand. You're going to need some solder. The modern stuff hasn't got any lead in it, and I've been told that it's not the best. So if you can find the stuff with lead on eBay, so much the better. I've been told that's a cool move to do. You're also going to need a solder sucker. We're going to come across that when working on the keyboards, because it you melt the solder, then the solder sucker just sucks the solder off the joint, so leaving it clean, so you can just break the joint nice and easily. The other thing you're going to need is a continuity checker. It's just something I use, a multimeter with a resistance setting. So when I put the two prongs together, it tells me, yes, you've made a contact. So I can test the circuit to make sure that I have got a contact or not. We're going to come across that on the video side of things as well. So overall, that shouldn't cost too much. I mean, a second-hand BBC costs you about £30 to £50, roughly, thereabouts. The MMC card reader costs about £25. If you want to hook up a floppy, which I'll be looking at, that's probably going to a PC floppy and a cable, what, £10, £15. You can probably get one off a second-hand PC, because not a lot of running floppy drives these days. And some components. I think the SCART project is going to cost about £10, in terms of little bits and pieces. So we're looking at about £100, just a bit over, thereabouts, depending on a few things. What you've already got, what you haven't. And you might, if you've got a relative who's a component level buff, then see if they can teach you to solder, because that will come in handy. My soldering is not the best. Fortunately, we're also going to be working, I think, simply with resistors, and they don't matter which way you get them round, so there's a lot of leeway here, a lot of leeway for mistakes. And we're going to come across that, like I say, in the video section. So, yeah, see you on the next video.